Today I'm going to talk about the authentication options available within GoAnywhere MFT. We call the authentication options login methods in the application, so under the users and then login methods section. So here we have the GoAnywhere default login method where we actually can just authenticate the accounts against GoAnywhere's backend database. That's the default out of the box login method. But we also have the ability to integrate GoAnywhere MFT with your LDAP server or Active Directory server. We have a basic authentication option, or we have an LDAP managed option. So basic just means that we're going to authenticate the account against the AD or LDAP server. LDAP managed means we're actually going to perform a sync process to create accounts automatically within the application. So again, we support Active Directory. We also have support for other LDAP server types listed here. And if it's outside this list, we have generic LDAP as an option as well. And then this login method is available for both your admin account type as well as the end user accounts or web user account types. So going to create a LDAP managed login method, we can see that you're able to define the schedule for the sync process, which again, you're defining how often GoAnywhere is going to be reaching out and checking your AD or LDAP groups for user accounts to then pull them into the application. When those accounts are pulled into GoAnywhere and then created within the application, we define or associate a template with this login method, which controls how the account is actually created within GoAnywhere when the sync process is pulling them into the application. Outside of the default login method, as well as the LDAP managed login method or LDAP basic login method, we also have the ability to leverage SAML authentication. And we support the SAML 2.0 protocol. So basically, we can integrate with any SAML 2.0 provider, which would be, you know, Okta, for example, or Ping Federates, or Azure Intra ID, or previously known as Azure AD, but all the options there. And this, again, is available for both the web user and admin user account types. One nice feature with the SAML single sign-on login method type is that we also have the ability to create accounts automatically from a SAML assertion. So if the account doesn't yet exist in the application and the account has access, you know, to GoAnywhere through the IDP, for example, then we'll create the account automatically through the SAML assertion. And again, we associate a template that controls how the account gets created in GoAnywhere when we're using the auto creation option for SAML authentication, or we call it the just-in-time provisioning option or functionality within GoAnywhere for SAML SSO. And then looking at the web user account specifically, so we often get the question of, you know, what we support for, you know, accounts that are logging in over SFTP, for example, very common protocol. So I go into a user account that has SFTP access, for example. On the authentication tab for the user account, we define how the account should be authenticating over SFTP. So we have password authentication, we support public key authentication, we can allow for either, or we can require both key and password. The nice thing about GoAnywhere is that we actually have built-in key vaults in the application to easily manage and store and also organize your keys. So for this account, when I want to associate a key for authentication for the account, I would click on the More Settings option here next to the account name, then go to SSH Keys. I can then associate a key by importing it directly on this page, or I can add it from a key vault as well. And if I go into my key vaults here, my key vault options, I can then select a key from the within the vault within the dropdown there as well. Give me 1 second here. I'm actually going to delete this key from here so I can give you better screenshots. Done. If I want to associate a key with a key or keys to an account, authenticating over, you know, authenticating is a public key over SFTP, I go to SSH keys. I can either import the key directly from this page, or I can add an existing key that's already within one of our key vaults. I can then select my test key there, my example key, and that's associated to the account, and I can authenticate to GoAnywhere over SFTP with this key. Okay, so then moving on to the MFA options within the application. Under the login settings, two-factor authentication, we also support a GoAnywhere one-time password option where we can email or text message a second factor challenge or code to the end user, either an admin account or web user account. We also have the option to integrate with a one-time password app. So we call out Google Authenticator here, but this also could be Duo or Okta or Microsoft Authenticator would all be options. We also support the Radius or RSA Secure ID as a two-factor authentication option in the application. And lastly, we have login method routing. So in a scenario where we need to support multiple different login method types across your user base simultaneously, so we have some accounts logging in using GoAnywhere, some accounts logging in using SAML authentication, some logging in using LDAP or AD integration, we can define a login method routing rule to evaluate the user account name pattern to then control which login method type they should be routed to. So very helpful in situations where we need to have SAML authentication with GoAnywhere login method for external accounts, for example, that maybe aren't managed within SAML or LDAP or your AD server. We can support all those login method types simultaneously. And let me clean this up for a second for a better screenshot. Okay, I can't even remove that apparently. Just change, can't delete that now. Let me just change this. A little bit better for just a screenshot here for the actual demo. Different examples, different login methods. We're then supporting simultaneously across the different username patterns here.